Hello everyone, this is Ella, your affiliate advisor in Ireland. Welcome back to my channel, All About Ireland. You know, recently I purchased a house and I moved into this house exactly 6 weeks ago, and I'm really enjoying it. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the 8 steps that I had to go through in this house buying purchase process. Without further ado, let's just dive in. The 8 steps are actually very simple on paper. You know, first step is save for the deposit, budget for all the expenses that you need to spend on once you move into the house, apply for mortgage, get your approval in principle, and then work with the estate agent, select the house. Once you're fine with the house and this is the one you need to move into, then go sale agreed. The fifth step, you can do it while you're doing fourth, but once you are sure and you paid the booking deposit amount, you can select the solicitor. And solicitor will help you, you know, in the process of signing the contracts and set everything up for you. And then you sign the contracts. Seventh step is basically, you know, get the house snagged, surveyed. That actually will help you in finding out all the issues and have the vendor and the builder get it corrected before you move into the house. And the last step is getting the insurance sorted and drawing down and taking the keys to your dream house. Let me go into further detail into each of these steps so that you get some idea about what each of these steps are. Step one, actually, I made a video. I'm going to post the link within the video description. It is actually more elaborate than what I'll be going through in this particular video. First step is to save for the deposit and budget the expenses. You know, the deposit for first-time buyers is actually 10% of the target house price. For the second-time buyers, which are not non-FTBs, you know, it's 20% of the target house price. The first-time buyers can also consider a help-to-buy scheme, which will actually help them pay their taxes, use their taxes towards 10% of the deposit that we are going to use. Again, I also made a video on HTP scheme. I'll be posting that in the video description. Apart from that, you have expenses like 1% stamp duty, legal fees, survey costs, valuation report costs. And then once you move into the house, you need to get the flooring done, you need to buy the furniture, you need to get the blinds, you need to buy the garden tools to, you know, there are a lot of such expenses. In my experience, what I found is the 10% of the deposit that I'm paying towards the target price, I'm paying the same 10% towards getting everything done within the house and paying for the additional expenses. So that's a good thumb rule that you can use. But again, you get a few months to set the house, so you can always phase yourself and plan yourself on when to move what, when to buy what. The second step is applying for mortgage. I made a very detailed video on what documents are required for AIP and how you can get AIP exemption if your AIP is not good enough to purchase the house. Again, I'll be putting the link down in the description. You can use bonkers.ie to compare the products, to look at the interest rates from each of the banks. There are green mortgages, which are given to A1, A2, A3 rated houses, which are lower in interest rate. So again, you also get few mortgages where there's bonus, few mortgages, there's no bonus, but cheaper interest rate. There's this key word, which is on offer letters and the AIPs, which is called APRC. Don't be worried about APRC. Just look at the interest rate that you're going to pay for next 3 years or 4 years. But at the end of this term, you get a couple of new options from the bank. You can choose one or you can switch banks for lower interest rates. APRC is basically calculated in this way. So first 5 years, let's say your interest rate is 2.7. And from 5 years on, the banks usually calculate the maximum variable rate, which is 4.3 in my case. So they add them up and average it out and say 3.7. But that's not the true interest rate you are paying. In my opinion, I also said in one of my videos, I feel the interest rates are going to further go down unless until there's something which brings them up. Step three, again, I made a very elaborate video on how to choose between old house and new house. What are the things you need to look for around the house? So choose the house you want, because it's not the area, sometimes the house you live in, which matters most. For us, it did matter most. But again, if you're buying your old house, check the BER rating, check everything that is around the house, what kind of neighbors you have, crime rate, if the garden size is good, if there are any parks around, amenities, and any schools around if you have kids. The fourth step is where, you know, you chose the house and you want to move in, so you pay a booking deposit. Some estate agents take 5K, some estate agents take 10K, This booking deposit is refundable. You can change your mind till you sign the contracts. And thing is, you can still hunt for houses. Even if you paid the booking deposit, this should not stop or deter you from going for the next best house or the best house better than this one. Step five is nothing but selecting the solicitor. And a few people, they select the solicitor even before they go hunting for the house. But in my case, once I went sale agreed, it took a couple of days for me to find the right solicitor, right price. Again, this is my story here though. Again, the solicitor fees within Dublin, they range from 900 to 3000, depending on the house size and the cost of the house. When you are negotiating with the solicitor, always look for what's included, what's excluded, if they're charging anything additional for conveyancing on top of the fees they have, any outlay charges and stuff. What happens is once you pay the booking deposit towards the house, which is 5K or 10K, depending upon the builder, you then engage a solicitor, you give the contacts to the estate agent, and the estate agent will have the vendor solicitor send the contracts to the solicitor. Solicitor is a very important part of the process. A bad solicitor can give you a lot of headaches, so choose wisely. Once you've selected the solicitor and solicitor gets the contracts for you to sign, on the day of signature, you basically pay the rest of the money, which is the actual deposit, which is 10% of the house price, minus the booking amount which you paid to the estate agent or to the vendor before you started engaging the solicitor. You pay the rest to your solicitor, and then solicitor transfers the money as well as sends the signed contracts back to the vendor. If you're purchasing old house, you basically get your survey done before signing contracts, because you would know how much you need to spend additionally on the old house based on the condition of the house. You usually get 21 days from the time the vendor solicitor sends the contract to your solicitor. If you break contracts, you may lose the entire deposit, but the right opportunity to ask solicitor all the questions you have around the parking, the common road, public space, private space, water connections, whatnot. Ask as many questions, a number of questions which you can ask that will actually help you down the process. The next step is, now you have the contract signed, you paid entire deposit, so you think it's a time for you to get the house. But again, before you take the house, get it surveyed, get it snagged, check for cracks. I know you can snag it yourself, but I would suggest you to go for a professional snagger so that they get to see a lot of things. Even after snagging, after you move in, you know, you still find few issues in the new house or the old house. If it's a new house, the builder will have a couple of clauses within the contracts that will actually help you. Whereas in the old house, I don't think there'll be such kind of clauses. But again, use this opportunity between your signed contracts to actually drawing down to find all the issues and try to get it fixed them fixed and get it fixed by the builder or by your seller who is selling his house. Last step is actually a combination of few steps, but it is one last straw towards getting your house keys. So once you sign the contracts, you also sign the letter of offer, which is from the bank. You can sign it on DocuSign, or you can sign it at your solicitor's office, because solicitor gets the letter of offer from the bank. You also get few documents from the bank and things later he'll ask you to sign. So you basically, you can go to solicitor's office and sign them, or you can sign it on DocuSign if you can do it all yourself. So once you sign your letter of offer, they'll ask you to get valuation report done. For valuation report, you talk to bank's panel. And then there are two instances you need to sort, that is mortgage protection insurance and home insurance. These two are mandatory. I find a lot of people having troubles in getting the mortgage protection or home insurance sorted. In my case, I went with the mortgage provider, which is Bank of Ireland. I chose the mortgage protection insurance and home insurance from the same provider, so I had no hassle. There was a lot of peace of mind for me in this case, in the last step. And then once everything is ready, once you know the date of keys handover, once you know the house is ready and the builder wants to give you the keys, then you notify the bank. But again, before you notify the bank, the solicitor, your solicitor comes back to you asking permission to request the bank for transfer of funds. You Say yes only when you have a date. If you do not have a date, don't say yes. Get a date, which is again, please hand over date, and then ask your solicitor to request bank. But you also can deal directly with the bank if you want to stop the transfer of funds. So once you draw down, once the vendor gets the amount, you have the case, and you know, you enter this lovely new house or second hand house, which you really loved and wanted to live longer within that particular house. That's it. These are 8 simple steps. They look simple, but you know, you'll go through a lot of emotions and stresses, and you know, you get depressed sometimes. And sometimes you have, you know, you enjoy the process. And again, yeah, it's something I went through, and at the end, I'm happy. I think you will be happy even if you have a few ups and downs on the way. Thank you for watching the video. I'll also put down the mortgage playlist, which I've been building for, you know, to help people like you to ease your house buying process. So I'll have the step one, step two, step three videos, as well as the playlist within the video description. Take a look at them. This particular video is sponsored by kalelander.com. They are a one-stop platform for job hunting in Ireland. They provide services around career counseling, CV prep, mock interviews. They have been great. I heard a lot about them. They do have a lot of rave reviews. Do check out their website, www.kalelander.com. Thank you for watching. Enjoy your day.